And of course, this one is not letting us out alive. Of course, Dark Samus is here again. I don't know how she survived that. But this is Dark Samus, supercharged with Phazon Energy. Target's Phazon Energy weaponry and defense systems are at full power. Phazon exposure has rendered Dark Samus invisible to your Dark Visor. Alright, so I don't think there's anything we can do about her in this form right now. Yeah, she's just got too much Phazon. She's completely invincible here. I think she's rare enough for something. Oh god! It's like some kind of hyper beam. Maybe this isn't the Zero Laser. This isn't Smash Brothers Brawl. Okay, I think we can get to the Echo Visor and actually see her. Yeah, then we can rip into her with our Annihilator Beam here as much as I can. Yep. Ammo is done. Let's see if I can shoot a super missile in there. Oh wait, I think... Yeah, she's visible again, so she's invulnerable. Of course, we got an energy recharge, but we did not get an ammo recharge, so... I still do have some light beam ammo, gotta keep that in mind. Let's see if I can get a super missile in there somehow. Yeah, if we could just hit her point-blank range. Okay, she's back into our... Okay, what is that? Shooting Phazon at us. And the timer is still going, so if we run out, game over. So that's why this is super stressful! Okay, is this something else? Oh yeah, this is a new form. What is this? Dark Samus 4, unstable Phazon energy form. Target can generate shield, immune to all forms of attack except Phazon energy. Draw and expel Phazon for use as a weapon. Okay, is there anything else I can read on that? Dark Samus has temporarily become a pure, yet unstable Phazon energy. Or something like that. She can generate a shield that is invulnerable to all attacks save one, blast of Phazon energy itself. Use your charge beam to collect Phazon energy that she expels, then fire it back at her. Direct hits will overload and disrupt her essence. Okay, guess we'll do that then. Get the charge beam going. Are we just playing volleyball here? Oh, it's Phazon energy like that. Okay, get her! Okay, we did overload her right there. Okay, so it's not the Phazon blast, it's like the little bits that come out the top, I guess. Yeah, so it's not that. We can't absorb that. That's like a power bomb blast or something like that. Okay, so is she actually vulnerable in this form? She is. Okay. What? Try to slam a super missile in there. Point blank range again. Okay. We're just gonna have to get right in her face and just launch it. Okay, that's not working. Yeah, when she does that shield with it, that's not gonna work. Okay, gotcha. Did that do anything? Okay, invulnerable again. Okay, she's going back into the cocoon. Okay, let's try to gather up that Phazon. Come on. This is the stuff. Gotcha. Okay, that didn't work that time. Why didn't that work? Did I not get enough? Why is it hurting me now? It didn't hurt me before. Looks like it's over now. Don't get too close, she'll do the shield. Oh yeah, by the way, the save point right before the Emperor Ring does not work anymore, so don't worry, I didn't miss an opportunity to save or anything like that. Okay, absorb it up, come on. And hit her! Okay, got her. Okay, that's doing good damage. I think we're in good shape here. This is really scary, but I think we're in good shape. Again. Maybe I have to be further back. I'm losing my grip on the nunchuck again. Okay. Hey, come here. Why does that hurt me? I don't understand. Why does it work sometimes and it doesn't work other times? Okay, work. Okay, it worked that time. Out of the way, you. Okay, let's just try the light beam for this one. Let's try spamming it with the light beam. I still do have... I have a little bit of light beam ammo left. Okay, back to charge beam. It's 3 minutes and 30 seconds left. Come on! Almost there! Oh, God! Come on. One more round of that should work. Okay, that's another super missile. Come here. Is this gonna work? Yes! We did it! Oh! Oh. That is going to do it for Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, everyone. Whew. You know, I don't think I fully knew what I was getting when I signed up for Veteran Mode there. Oh boy. That was a game, though. Definitely much longer than the first Prime. A lot more to it. A lot more expansive. A lot more to collect there. So, what do I think of Metroid Prime 2 now that it's over? It's a really good game. I really like it. I would not call this a bad or an average or an okay game. By any stretch of the imagination, I think this is a really good game. Far behind the first Prime, I just have to say it. You know, I said throughout the playthrough, and I even opened up with that they really wanted to try their own thing here. Retro really wanted to leave its own marks. And, you know, it came with a lot of new stuff. You know, like a lot of new things came, and I really kind of appreciate that experimentation, really. I think a lot of it doesn't really meld with the Metroid universe that well. Ammo limits? Don't really know about that one. Because, of course, missile has always been an ammo with limits on it, right? You could never just spam missiles in any of the games, even dating back to the 2D ones. But you always had your trusty beam, and you could upgrade that, so you were never using the base power beam just as it came to deal damage when you ran out of ammo. But in this one, all you have is the power beam. That's the only thing you have that doesn't operate on any ammo right there. So, I don't know, when you got into situations where maybe you ran out of ammo and you were relying on the power beam or the missiles didn't really work that well, you were kind of screwed because you had to use the regular power beam. The battle with the Chica comes to mind, where it was just too fast for the dark beam ammo, as well as the light beam ammo, I think, in the cocoon phase there. So, and I think a lot of the ways the boss battles are kind of built around the various ammos kind of hurts the game in its entirety. You guys will notice that's when I got really frustrated. It was the boss battles in a lot of these. One, for not really knowing what to do all the time, and two, a lot of the limitations they put on you kind of make it really frustrating. And I know the result of that isn't really like that it's a bad game inherently. It's just they were trying some new stuff, and maybe it doesn't really hit as home for me as it would other people that are looking for new stuff. That really hammers home in the Emperor Egg fight. I was getting legitimately frustrated there. And although Dark Samus, I was expecting, you know, I might die on Dark Samus and have to do all that over, and that would have been really, really bad. But Dark Samus I didn't really have a problem with, although I still don't really get why some of those phase-on volleys didn't work. But the Emperor Egg was kind of the prime example of that, right? How the Power Beam, for all intents and purposes, was completely useless. How you had to get lucky trying to shoot the super missiles in there in order to get to its vulnerability phase, because you can't waste ammo on the invulnerable phase, because you need the ammo from the vulnerable phase. So, I don't know, I feel like the ammo wasn't a really good idea, and Retro does kind of backpedal that in the next game. There's no ammo in that one whatsoever. But other than frustration of boss battles and some of those ammo mechanics, I think it's very solidly put together. I think the pacing is a little off compared to the first Prime, like I mentioned before. The first Prime seemed to flow a lot better. You were never in one area too often, so I think ultimately Prime 1 is definitely the superior game in that way, but Metroid Prime 2, still worth your time. You know, if you can pick it up on the Metroid Prime trilogy, definitely recommend it. Still prefer the motion controls there. And I think other than those few compartments right there that I do have complaints with, it's really, really is a solid game, including the story, which I guess you could argue is kind of an upgrade over the first Prime. Kind of the same thing, you know, Doomsday Meteor hits the planet and stuff happens after there, but it's going to be the next game where all this kind of really ties together and we find out what exactly the role Phazon has in all of this, because Metroid Prime 2 doesn't really explain to us how the Phazon got here, or Phazon isn't really a core component right there other than supposedly creating the Ing. So hopefully that's more things that will get answered in the next game there. And maybe it'll even come back in Metroid Prime 4. I really have no clue. But man, just reading the plight of the Luminoth there too, that might make it better than the Chozo plotline in the first game to me. Because for the Chozo plotline in the first one, you just kind of read the lore that they've left behind. But in Metroid Prime 2, you see the bodies, man. And that kind of really makes it hit even closer to home for me. Not really hit close to home, but really hits the plot home for me there. But that is going to be it for Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, everyone. But let's see what we got here. Yep, 100% completion. Total time, 14 hours. Hyper mode difficulty active. I will not be playing this game on hyper mode, as veteran was more than enough for me. But that is going to be all for Metroid Prime 2 Echoes, everyone. I hope you guys enjoyed the playthrough. I enjoyed it for the most part. A few frustrating things there. But next time on the Metroid Prime trilogy, we will be going into Metroid Prime 3 Corruption, which I do think is probably a better game than this from what I remember. But that's going to be part of the fun in playing again. So until then, this is Virgo signing off.